Hi viewers, this is Meenakshindra Mansito. Welcome to my channel. You are watching Ganesh Tutoriums. Are you all ready to learn? Let me start the class.
So example 2, page number 178. If angle B and angle Q are acute angles such that sine of B is equal to sine of Q. Prove that angle B equal to angle Q. Are you all clear? Excuse me. Actually, we are supposed to consider the two right angles. In this two right angle, excuse me, are you all clear? Example 2. In this example that they given, angle B and angle Q are the acute angles such that sine B is equal to sine Q, right? Sine Q. Then we need to prove that angle of B is equal to angle of Q, right? So it is acute angle. So we just draw the right angle triangle. So it is from the right angle triangle. So I just consider right angle triangle 1 and one more right angle triangle. Clear? Excuse me, are you clear? Because they given a two angle draw, right? Excuse me. So we just mark it A, C, B, right? Here P, R, Q, right? A, B, C and P, Q, R. So here right angle that R, here right angle that C. Then what they given? We need to prove angle B equal to angle Q. We need to prove these two angles are equal. But what they given here? The sine of the ratio of angle B, the sine of ratio, sine equal to angle B, that is opposite by adjacent, which is equal to here sine of Q opposite by adjacent is equal. Are you all clear? Excuse me. So we can write. Let we consider right angle triangle, the right angle triangle ABC and right angle triangle PR. Why? Is it clear only? No. Yes, it will come, baby. Just wait for the network. Okay. Now we consider the true right angle triangle. What they given in here? Sine of B equal to sine of Q, right? Excuse me. Are you all clear? Any other doubt? It's not a theta. Sine of Q, right? Chair. Now we all know that what is the sine? What is the sine in this triangle? Sine of P. Opposite by hypotenuse. What is the opposite side here? What is the opposite side here? AC. Very good. So we can write AC by, what is the hypotenuse? AB. Are you clear? We wrote sine B value, the sine B ratio. Now, sine Q ratio, what it is? Sine Q in this diagram, sine Q. Very good. Opposite, that is PR by PQ. Right? Clear? Excuse me? Okay, now. Listen, we all know that. Listen. When we solve, maybe for example, it is a some value, it is maybe a 10, here it may be a 15. When we are dividing 10 by 15, we will get one constant or not, right? Yes. So in this constant is here, sine of B, right? We said the ratio name is sine of B. It may be 10 by 15, maybe 10 by 15, it leaves the constant. So I just assume that constant is K. We should write C. Are you clear? Excuse me, actually in a problem, it's it. And sine of B equal to sine of Q. So sine of B, we know that opposite by hypotenuse, that is AC by AB, which is equal to here sine of Q, that is PR by PQ. For example, here it is a 10, here it is a 15. 10 by 15, it leaves a constant, some constant. When we are dividing this, we will get a constant, right? So the same constant, which is equal to when we are dividing PR by PQ, also it is same, right? Is it clear? Excuse me. Okay. Now it is very easiest one. You can write AC equal to, you just transpose the AB to the left side. So PR divided by PQ into AB. Clear? Which is equal to K. Excuse me, are you all clear? Excuse me. I just transpose the AP. Clear? Now we can transpose the PR this side. So AC, when you're transposing PR, this side became a divided by PR equal to, now PR is here, so 1, so AB by PQ equal to K. Are you all clear? Excuse me? I just transpose the AP to the right side, then PR to the left side. Excuse me, are you clear? Any other doubt? Okay, next step, AC by PR equal to K and AB by PQ is equal to K. Clear? Excuse me? Clear, any doubt? Okay, now. Next we can write, this AC is equal to K into PR. Shall I write like this? K into PR? Next. Here AB is equal to K into PQ. Is it right? Are you clear? Any doubt? Okay, now. Now we found AC and AB. Now I want to know the hypotenuse. What is the hypotenuse here? In this AB hypotenuse? AB only the hypotenuse, right? Okay, now. So we know that by the Pythagoras theorem, what it is? We need to find a BC. So AB is a hypotenuse. AB is a hypotenuse. AC is a one of the leg. CB is a one of the leg. So I know that hypotenuse. Now I can find what I supposed to find. Here I have a AC and AB. Now I need to find a BC value. Clear? So by Pythagoras theorem, we need to find BC. Are you all clear? Actually, we know the AC value, that is in terms of K into PR. AB also, we know that. In this diagram, we need to know the BC alone. So we can write a BC. What is the BC? Can anyone tell me? Excuse me? What is the Pythagoras theorem? The hypotenuse. Wait. Hypotenuse here. So hypotenuse, listen. I will write it here. Hypotenuse square is equal to leg square plus leg square, right? Excuse me? Okay. Now, what is the leg we supposed to find? One of the leg we supposed to find, right? So BC. One of the leg is BC. So we can write hypotenuse is AB. AB square is equal to AC square plus CB square, right? Two leg are AC and CB is a leg. Clear? Excuse me? Okay. Now, what we supposed to find? BC. That is CB. So CB square is equal to, what we supposed to write? AB square minus AC square, right? Excuse me? Are you clear? So now we can write the same thing. BC square is equal to AB squared minus AC squared. Clear? Real clear? Okay. Now the same thing for the second diagram. We supposed to find the QR. So what is the QR? QR squared is equal to, what it is? QR squared is equal to hypotenuse, what it is? PQ square minus PR square. Very good. PR square. Are you clear by any doubt? Excuse me? Okay. Now we can substitute the value. BC is equal to, it is a square root. So it has became a AB square minus AC square. Here also you should write QR is equal to root of PQ square plus PR square. Sorry, minus PR square. Clear? Any other doubt? Excuse me? Okay. Now we can find a BC divided by QR. BC divided by QR. So BC by QR. Clear? Excuse me? Okay. Now, what is the BC here? We found it here. Root of AB squared minus AC squared. Now, QR value. Root of PQ squared minus PR squared. Clear? So, now we can substitute the value. What is the AB we found it here? AB. What is the AB? K into PQ. So, root of AB squared, you can write K into PQ the whole square. Shall I write like this? Okay. Minus AC value. K into PR the whole square. Clear? You can can keep a dot here. The dot, in a sense, here it is a multiplication divided by. Now, PQ the same value. We didn't find any other value for PQ. So, PQ square minus PR square. Are you all clear? Any other doubt? Excuse me?
Okay.
Now, K into PQ squared. So, we can down the square. K squared PQ squared minus K squared PR squared. Right? Because the square is common. Divided by root of what it is? PQ squared minus PR squared. Okay. Now, in a both term, K is common. So, when you are taking out a common, it became a K. Right? So, K into root of PQ squared minus PR squared divided by PQ squared minus PR squared, right? Excuse me, are you clear? In this two term, K squared is common. So, you can take a K squared as a common one. Then K squared, it is in a root. So, when you are taking K squared as a out of root, it became a K. Clear? Excuse me? So, now these two are the common. So, you can cancel it. P squared minus PR squared, root of P squared minus PR squared, and P squared minus PR squared. So, remaining, what is the value? Only K. Clear? Excuse me? So, BC by, now you can write, what we found it? BC by QR equal to K. Now, we found here, right? Excuse me, are you clear? Excuse me? Okay, in before the problem itself, what we assumed here, AC by, see here, AC by PR equal to AB by PQ, C equal to K, right? Excuse me. Okay, you can write it now. Now, the general form, AC by PR equal to AB by PQ, which is equal to K, because from this we write K, right? Excuse me, are you clear? Excuse me? Okay. Now the same thing. Instead of K value, you can substitute this. So, AC by PR equal to AB by PQ equal to, instead of K, you can put a BC by QR. Are you clear? Excuse me, are you all clear? Actually, what it means, the ratio of AC side. Listen, what it is means, listen, see here, see the book. Listen, okay. Now you can see the book. Actually, the ratio of when you are dividing AC by PR, it is leaves us some constant. The constant which is equal to, when you find the ratio of AB by PQ, it is equal to the same constant. Then when you are taking ratio for QR and CB, it is also leaves the same constant. Are you all clear? When you are taking ratio for this two side, it is the same. And this two side, it is the same. This two side, it is the same. So, what it means? Excuse me? What it means? The angle should be equal. And the side should be... No, the sides not be equal, BB. The sides are in a proportional. Listen, here it is a 1. Maybe, for example, here it is 1, here it is 2. What is the ratio for this? 1 by 2. Clear? Excuse me? And the same thing, here may be a 4, here may be a 8. What is the answer? Sorry, 4, 8, 1 by 2. Which is equal to here 3, here 6. Sorry, 3, here 6. What it is? 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. So, all the sides are in a proportional, right? When you are multiplying some number with these sides, it became a this sides. Clear? When you multiply the some constant with the sides of a triangle ABC, this... When you are multiplying some constant with the sides of ABC, it will give the sides of a PQR. Right? Clear? So, we conclude that it is a congruent or not. Excuse me? Okay. So, the triangle ABC congruent to triangle, what it is? PQR. Right? So, now these two triangles are congruent. So, in this two triangles are congruent. Now, the corresponding angles are equal or not? Excuse me. These two triangles are congruent. Now, you can tell me these two triangles congruent. So, the corresponding angles equal or not? So, the corresponding angle in the sense angle A equal to angle P and comma next, therefore next angle C equal to angle R, next angle B P equal to angle Q, right? Are you all clear? So what we supposed to prove here? Prove that angle P is equal to angle Q. Now we prove that angle P is equal to angle Q or not? So hence prove that. Are you clear, baby? Any other doubt? Excuse me, are you all clear?
I hope in this video you make clear about the problem. Thank you for watching my video. If it is any doubt, you can ask me in a comment.